Hello everyone, welcome to the next lecture on the probability and statistics. Today we will discuss about how you can solve the one sample t test problems. Myself, Dr. Garg, working in the School of Mathematics, Thapar Institute. So what we have discussed so far is that in our last lectures we have seen how you can solve the J test. So this is the formula for the J test, and provided that n must be a greater than of the 30, or you can say this is a large sample. But what will happen if your sample size is my small? Then this formula, that is this Z statistics or the Z test, will not be follows the normal distribution. What is the meaning of that? It means that all those critical values which we have used in the Z test are no longer correct. Or what you can say that in our large sample, we know that up to the 95% is confidence interval. We know the sample size, sample mean lies within 1.96 of the standard deviation. But whenever this condition does not hold, then you can't say that the mean sample mean will lies between them. In order to handle all these overcomings, there is a need to study when the sample size is small. For this person, that is this is the Englishman, that is W.S. Gossett, in 1908 derived this formula for the small sample. So this is derived for the random samples of the size n, and n must be less than of the 30. And this result is published by him under this nickname, or called as pen name, as a students. And once the result is published, and since then the statistics is known as the student t test. So you can see this is also named as the student. What is the S in this case? Is the S is nothing but the unbiased sample variance, and the formula is written as here. And the denominator, that is the n minus 1, is called as the degree of freedom. What is the meaning of the degree of freedom? Because this is the new terms associated with these statistics. So for example, if you have the 7 boxes are there, and your target is to choose one box in a day. So in the day 1, how many choices you have to select these 7 boxes are there. So how many choices you have? So you have the 7 choices. So say this is the box 1 you have chosen the day 1. How many choices you have in the day 2? Now you have the only 6 boxes. So it means how many choices you have in this? This is 6, 5. Similarly, in the third case, you have the third day, you have the 5 choices. In this case, 4, and so on. So what is the meaning of that? Whenever you have the 2 choices in the day 6, how many choices in the 7th day? There is no choice. Why? Because there is only one box left behind that. So what is the meaning of that? So therefore, what you conclude? So out of these 7 days, how many choices, how many days you have to, how many choices you have in a day? That is the 6th days are there. It means in general, you can say that degree of freedom is my n minus 1. So if I say the sample consists of say 21 elements, then what is the degree of freedom is? 20. Now, the important remark will be here. If the population variance, all of you know that if x follows the normal distribution like here, then this sigma will be called as the population variance. So once the population variance is unknown to you, then how you can solve the problem? So if it is unknown, then either you can use the large sample test, or you can use the small sample test. All of you know that large sample test we already covered in the last lecture, that is called as the J test. And for the small sample, we will call as the T test. And whenever this is a large sample or the large sample, then this, the estimator of this sigma square, that is a sample population variance, is called as the sample variance, as small s square. And it is defined as here. And you can apply the J test. On the other hand, when it is a small sample, then we will call as the, this is a, remember that this is my capital S, and this capital S is called as the unbiased estimator. And from here, if you can clearly see that if you divide them, small s square upon capital S square, so what will happen? This is nothing but n minus 1 upon small n. So can you find the capital S from here? You can easily find that capital S is nothing but here. So you can use either this formula, or you can use either this formula, that's both have the same meaning. What is the assumption behind that when you apply for the student t test? Remember that this test is used to compare the means. So whenever you have that, you have the mean, population mean, you have to compare them with the help of student t test. So what is the assumption behind that? Whatever the sample you have taken, it must be randomly selected. And from where you have to taken the sample, that is a population from which you are sampling, it must follows the normal distribution. Now, what is the test for the one sample are there? So we will discuss about the simple three steps rules are there. So what are those three steps? We will firstly define what is the null, what is the hypothesis. That is, we will define firstly what is the null hypothesis and what is the alternative hypothesis. Then we will try to compute the statistics value, and then finally we will conclude the here. How you define the hypothesis, that we already discussed in our last lecture, how you define the null and alternative. You can watch them previous video. Otherwise, the step one will be my how you define the null hypothesis and alternative. So what is that? If you want to compare your population mean to be say 7, then this capital D is represent for my some specific task. We will see in the couple of examples. What is the opposite of this is here? If it either it can be not equal to, either it can be greater than, or it can be less than. So if it is not equal to, then we call as the two tail. If it is a greater than or less than, either of the case, we call as the one tail. This is the step one. After that, we will try to compute this capital T value here by using this. Capital S is my unbiased estimator of sigma, which is defined by either of the way are there. And the step third, we will see the conclusion, how you can conclude them. We will compute the degree of freedom. And then if this is the test for the one tail, this is for the one tail. And we will compute this value based on this degree of freedom. This new is the degree of freedom. Once you will hear, then how you can reject or accept the value. We will find this value small t and locate this value here. If this value lies in the shaded portion, that is, if it is greater than of this for the one tail, or if in the two tail lies in the shaded portion, then it will be the rejected. And alpha is called as the level of significance. How you can read this value are there? So since this is the most important task, how you can read this value from the T table? So look at this is the T table. You can simply write the T table on the Google. So you can find the T table PDF. This is the file. So for example, how you can read them? This 0.0, this value is called as the 5% level of significance. We call as the alpha. And this 5 is called as the degree of freedom. How you can read this value? You can see here is a one tail and here is a two tail. There are two values are there. So that's why I'm written here. So firstly, you want to find the two tail. Look at this table, this line, level of significance is my 5%. So look at the level of significance is my here. Degree of freedom we need as a 5. So look at the value of the 5 here. Then you can find the corresponding value is 2.571. You can see here. On the other hand, if you are working on the one tail, so you can search on here as the 5%. This is now 5%. Degree of freedom will be now my 5. So what is the value of here is 2.015 is there. So this is the way you can locate at the values. Now we will see as say 10 examples in this video, 8 to 10 examples in this video, which will help you to understand more easily. So look at this one. Is your first target is to identify that whether it's a small sample or the large sample. So this will be identified with the help of the n. So if n is less than 30, then it will be the small. If n will be the greater than 30, then it will be the large. So look at that. The 10 cartons are taken as random from the automatic machines. So this is just the information. So n is my nothing but the 10. The mean net weight of the 10 cartons. So this is a mean of the only 10. So this is my sample mean. That is the 11.8. This is the standard deviation of these 10 cartons are there. So this is a small s. This is not the population B. So you can see this number is less than 30. So that means this is my small sample. So how you can write that? So what is that? Your first step will be define the hypothesis. How you can define the hypothesis? You can see you have to take a decision that sample mean differs significantly from the mean of weight 12 or not. So what is that? They simply ask whether, what is that? This is simply ask they are not equal to 12. They are not preferring that the mean is greater than or less than. They simply said it's differs significantly. So since equality does not belong to this, so it belongs to the H1. So what is the opposite of this is my equality is there. Now since it is not equal to, so it's a two tail. You can watch the previous video like how to can write the H0 and H1 in complete detail. That will consist of the 15 examples which will help you to understand is more easily. Now what is the step number two is we will try to compute this value. So if we want C, if you substitute the value of the x bar, what is the mu is? Mu is nothing but my 12 if you substitute here, but the capital S is unknown to you. This is a small s given to you. How you find the capital S? We can substitute the value here. N is given to you as a 10, small s is given to you as a 1.5, and 10 minus 9 is 1. So after the calculation, you will get as a s square is my this. So what is the value of the s from here? This is nothing but my square root of this. So once you will calculate this value, it comes to as a minus 4. Now once you will compute the value of there, then we will go on the step 3. We will draw. Now you can see this is the not equal to, so it will be my two tail. You have to draw the graph like this way. Now the level of significance is not given to you, so it means it is a 5%. What is the degree of freedom in this case? There are the 10 elements, so the degree of freedom is my 9. So from the table you can find the value of the 9 at the level of significance 5. Also it can be written like this way. These are the same meaning. So you can see this is the, for the two tail, the value is my 2.26. So it's a two tail, you have to write on the both side. What is the value of this capital T, small t, we have computed minus 4. So you can see the minus 4 lies on here. So it lies in the rejected region. So it means H0 is rejected. So we accepted this one. So that is H1 is accepted. So since minus 4 is less than of this, so we rejected H0. So H0 is rejected, so it means this is accepted. How you write this line? It means we conclude that with the 95% is the sample mean, what is the meaning of the not equal is, differ significantly from the mean of 12. So this is the way you can solve them. Now we will follow the same procedure for the remaining 8 examples. Suppose your company wants to improve the sales. The past sale indicates that the average sale is my 100 per transition. So look at that, whether it's a sample mean or the population mean. So this is the average sale of the past data. How many data consist of? Whether it's a 10 information, 12 information, 1000 information. It is nothing given. It means this is my population mean. After training your sale, the recent sale data of the 25 salesmen. So the sample consists of the 25 elements. Sale of the 25 element, that's nothing but my X bar. Here, with the standard deviation, that's a small s, is my 15. Does the training work? So how you can claim that the training will work? So we will define the first step. So what do you conclude that when the training will work? What is the previous transition is? 100. So when the training will work? When your result will be more than of the 100. It can't be equality, because if it is equality, what is the meaning of that? So it means it will not be improved. So what you conclude that the training will be improved only when the sale will be more than of 100. Now since equality does not appear, so you can say H1 this will be here. So what is the opposite of this is? It will be less than equal to 100, or you can simply write as equality 100 is there. So that is where you can define that. Now since it is a strictly greater than sign, so it is a one tail. Now how you define the step number 2 is, we will try to compute this. So in order to find this, X bar you have, mu you have already, S is, you can compute from here, you can substitute the value this. This is the value of the S square. After finding the value of the S square, you can substitute this value in this. You will get the answer as 9.79. Step number 3 is, now since it is a one tail, what is the degree of freedom for this case is? N minus 1 is the 24. Since it is a one tail and the value of the capital T is the positive, so we can write only on the right hand side. If your capital T, if you find as a minus 9.79, then you will compute the shaded portion on the left hand side of this. Anyhow, now in this case is a positive sign. So what is the degree of freedom you have is 1.71. This value is my here. Now you can see the value of this is 9.79. Where it lies that? It lies here. Again, it lies on the rejected portion. So you can see 9.79 lies, is a greater than 1.71. So we can reject the H0. This is rejected. So this is accepted. What is the meaning of that? Training will work on that. So we can say the sale training will probably be a success. Look at the another example. The mean weekly sale of the candy bar is this. So how many stores they have taken? It is not given. It means this is nothing but my population mean. After the advertisement, the week salary of the week sales of the 22 store. एवरेज विल बी माई हेयर एंड द स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन इज 17.2. वॉज द एडवर्टाइजमेंट कंपेनियन सक्सेसफुल? अगेन द सिमिलर थिंग इज देयर. वेन इट विल बी सक्सेसफुल? वेन इट विल बी ग्रेटर देन ऑफ द बिफोर एडवर्टाइजमेंट सेल. बिफोर एडवर्टाइजमेंट सेल वॉज दिस वन. सो इट मीन्स योर सेल विल बी ग्रेटर देन ऑफ दिस, देन इट विल बी सक्सेसफुल. सो अगेन इक्वालिटी इज नॉट अपियर हेयर. दिस इज माई एच वन इज देयर. सो यू कैन से दिस इज हेयर, और यू कैन राइट दिस इज लेस देन इक्वल टू, और यू कैन सिंपली राइट एज इक्वालिटी. दैट मीन्स एडवर्टाइजमेंट इज नॉट सक्सेसफुल. स्टेप नंबर टू इज यू कैन कंप्यूट दिस वैल्यू अगेन. You can find this value. Since this value is not be given, so you can write this as a n s square upon n minus 1. After finding these values here, you will get this value. Substitute this value of the s square into here, you will get this value as 1.91. Again, since it is a greater than sign, so it is a one tail only, and this value is my positive, so you can compute that the step third is this. The degree of freedom is my 21, so you can compute the value as here. So what is the value of 1.97? Again lies in this shaded portion. So we can say it is rejected. H0 will be rejected. So this is rejected. It means this is accepted. So once this is accepted means the sale is advertisement successful. You can see the advertisement is successful. Look at the another one is there. So a new process is there. The average weight is greater than of the 5 carat. Average weight is greater than of the 0.5 carat. So since it is a strictly greater than, do the 6 measurement sufficient evidence to produce that in excess of the 0.5? So in the excess of the 0.5 means equality does not appear. So your target is to write like here. Again, this is a one tail, and opposite of this is the equality. Now, step number 2 is you have to write this one. This is the information given to you. X bar, how you find the mean of this? So since there are the 6 elements, you can find the mean by using this sum divided by n. You can find this value, or you can write here as a n s square upon n minus 1. But there is no need to use this because s square is not given to you. So 0.53 is given to you. So you can use this 0.53 square plus of the second value minus 0.53 square plus third value plus fourth value and so on, divided by how many n minus 1 is 5. So after the calculation you will get the s square as this. After substitute the value of the s square here, you will get the t here. Again, it is a one tail, so we can apply the step number 3. Degree of freedom is my 5. You can compute them as the level of significance 5% is of this. 1.32 lies here. It means it is accepted. Whenever the term is accepted, so you always use the word may. So we may accepted H0, or you can say we failed to rejected H0, or therefore what you conclude them. So you have to write the word as a may. So we, it means this is accepted and this is rejected. So we may conclude that there is no significant difference to indicate that whatever the given in the statement. Or you can say we do not provide the sufficient evidence to claim the result. Look at randomly quickly on the other hands. This is given to you. You have to regard that whether it is taken from the 56 as a mean or not. So this is the way you can write. You can write the H0. You can compute them. You will get this here. Since the degree of freedom is my 15, you can write this and it's a two tail. So what you can do that, you have to write on the both side. What is the degree of freedom is my 2.131 here. So this value minus 3 point lies here. This is my rejected H0. Shaded portion is always be rejected H0. So this is my rejected, this is accepted. So what you conclude that? We conclude that the data is not taken. This is rejected, this is accepted. It is not taken from the mean. Look at the second part is there. What is given to you? You have to find the confidence interval for the mean. What is the meaning of that? Your target is to find this value. So what is that? The level of significance, degree of freedom is given to be here. So your target is to find this. So this is the accepted reason. Can I write this term? Minus 2.1, this is the formula of this. Our target is to find the value of this mu. So what is given to you? You have to substitute all those values, x bar, you have to find the value of the s. You can substitute all the values in here and try to find the value of mu. Now you can multiply them on the both side. After the simplify, you will get this expression. Therefore, the confidence interval is my here. Look at the another one is there. Again, a professor wants to know whether the introductory statistics class has a good grasp for the basic math. So how they can claim that? They will take only six students at random. So n is my six. So firstly, you have to check whether it's up to the 90% confidence. The mean score on the test will be above the 70. Since equality does not appear here, so it means this is my H1. What is the opposite of this? It will be either less than equal to, or you can say simply less equality is there. So this is my here. What is the step number two is? You can compute the test statistics. You can use this formula for these six information. These six information are given to you. You can compute the mean by sum divided by n. This will be here. And once you will find the mean, and then you can see s here. You can substitute all value this, you will get here. Again, it is given to you as a one tail. So degree of freedom will be my. You can say what is the degree of freedom is? 5. You can substitute the value 5. Compute this value as 1.476. It's a one tail, and the value of this is computed as a positive. So you can take on the right hand side. 1.476 is my degree T value, critical value. 1.71 lies here. So since 1.71 is greater than 1.476, so we rejected H0. This is rejected. So what is the meaning of that? If this is rejected, means this is accepted. That is a average claim that the professor has evidence that the class mean would be at least, no, it's not be at least, would be more than of the 70, because this is a greater than sign. Look at the another one is there. A historical company wants to know whether the new fertilizer has improved the crop yield or not. How they can prove that? They will taken that historical will inform you that 20 acres per, so that's the total historical, that's the population. How they can decide that? They will taken as a sample farmer of observe this much and this much of the 12s are there. So this is given to you, x bar is given to you here, and standard deviation is given to you this. When it will be fertilized, when the new fertilizer work? So the new fertilizer will work when it will be more than of the historical one. So it will be more than of this means here. Again, equality does not appear. So this is my H1. What is the opposite of this here? Similarly, you can start with the step number two. You can use this formula for the S. All is given to you. S is given to you. X bar is given to you. N is given to you. You can substitute the value. You will get this result. Now, step number three is, now it's a one tail and this value is the positive. You can write this value here. Level of significance is 5% and the degree of freedom is 11. So this is here. The value of the capital T is my 0.91. So it lies here. So it means we may accept H0. Always remember, whenever it lies in the accepted region, we always use the word as a may. So we may accept it at zero, or you can say we fail to reject it the H0. So what is the meaning of that? We accepted, we may accepted this. So we can write that we may conclude that the new fertilizer process has improved the crop yield. Look at this one is there. So again, it is given to you as a 12 different form. So N is given to you this, and information is provided to you. Your target is to check from this 20 whether it is better or not. So again, you can try to yourself and let me know the answer in the comment box. So you have to provide the value of the small t. You have to provide whether it is accepted or not in the comment box. So I hope you can enjoy this session. It's very easy. We will see in our next class how you can solve the independent samples, two sample t test in our next class. Till then, you can simply follow this YouTube channel link for finding the other testing of hypothesis. All you can find in this channel name, Dr. Harishkar. Best of luck, students. Happy learning.